Let's get back to taxes. Our favorite topic, right? The president is suggesting that raising the federal gas tax, and he would like to do that, and he's also in favor of an internet sales tax. What? Grover Norquist, Americans for Tax Reform president, joining us now. Grover, I would suspect you're not a big fan of either of those ideas.
Well, there's not going to be a gas tax. The House and the Senate are not going to pass a gas tax, certainly not in an election year. As been pointed out, it would be devastating to Trump-voting states, and it would claw back for many middle-income people as much as 60% of the tax reduction that we just got them. It would it's a great idea for the Democrats to trick the president into saying, well, think about it, in order to sound polite. But the Democrats would go to town, and it would be a massive tax on middle-income Americans. If you want to put more money in roads, stop siphoning about 25% of it off into subways, and stop having the Davis-Bacon bill take another 25%, which makes everything cost more. Get rid of Davis-Bacon, stop siphoning the money off, and you have twice as much money for roads. You don't need to raise taxes.
Very good. And the internet sales issue, which has been around for a long time, that could generate a lot of revenue.
No, actually, it won't. No, because the big person in the game was Amazon, and Amazon is now in all 50 states. If you have a presence in 50 states, you pay taxes in 50 states. What the present Supreme Court decision, which says you can't tax across state lines, you can't take a Utah company that sells things to 49 states and have 49 states beat it up.
Right.
If that company expands, as now Walmart's into this, they're in all 57 states. Amazon's in all 50 states. The big guys are all paying taxes already. All this change would take, and there may be a Supreme Court decision that lets the states do this, would be to tax smaller companies that try and sell throughout the country from somebody's back room. It would hurt eBay, people who sell on eBay. It's a bad idea. I know the president was unhappy with Amazon, but he's about 15 years off in thinking that this would... Amazon's for this, okay? Maybe somebody needs it. The White House needs to tell the president. Amazon likes this. This is not a good idea. The tax on its competitors.
But, you know, the gas tax was kind of in reference to this infrastructure bill.
Yeah. Okay.
It seems to me, based on what the funding proposals are at this point, is that, that the consumers are going to pay more one way or another, whether it's road tolls or some form or fashion, that we're going to end up having to pay for a lot of these projects.
Well, there's a difference between a road toll for a new road or a widened bridge. The people who use it actually pay it. It's not a user fee when they take your gas tax because you drive up and down New Jersey highways, and they take it and they build highways or worse, subways somewhere else. That's not a user fee. It's a tax, excise tax, not a user fee. There's something to be said for user fees instead of raising other taxes. But the most important thing to do, and the president's talked about this, and it's the tax increase is not in his proposal. It was some sort of comment that he made. It was not, it's not written down. It's not in the proposal. The most important part of the proposal is taking the 10 years it can take to give a permit for any kind of expansion of infrastructure, broadband, energy facilities, and taking it to 2 years. It's estimated that that in 6 years would save $3-4 trillion by reducing the waiting cost on this stuff. That's the big win for taxpayers. You've got to get those permits fixed.
But Grover, you know, still a lot is on the backs of states and local governments, and they are notoriously difficult to deal with when it comes to these kind of projects. So, yes, you can streamline the federal process, but it can still get bogged down.
Okay. They're not going to allow giving money to states if they haven't actually got the permits ready.
Okay.
So the states will have to fix their permitting process. I know that people like to talk about infrastructure. This is about permitting reforms, which has a huge impact on fixing our infrastructure problems, which largely stem from ridiculously long permitting process, and everybody and their brother can sue to stop things. Remember those pipelines they were trying to build through Nebraska and North Dakota, and everybody sued, and they came up with all sorts of stupid reasons to delay it. A bunch of lawyers got rich, and it damaged middle-income people trying to make a living in those states, particularly in that industry.
Right.
The permitting win is a huge one. It makes the infrastructure fix much more valuable, and also the federal government will be a smaller percentage of these deals. The truly stupid things that get built are when the feds come in and say, we'll pay 90% for something that you wouldn't want yourself, but if we were paying for it, you'd do it.
Right.
That's where stupid comes in. If the feds are limited to 20% of a project, it still might be a mistake, but it's not prima facie stupid.
All right, I've got literally 20 seconds. Bill Gates, the billionaire founder of Microsoft, says he's paid over $10 billion in taxes, Grover, that the government should require people like him to pay even higher taxes. Very quickly, your response to Mr. Gates.
There's a website, pay.gov. Go to it, Bill Gates. I challenge you to put up or shut up. If you think you should pay more taxes, write a check. $2 billion is a good opening bid. But here's what you really think, Bill Gates. You think you're smarter than the government. You put your money in a foundation. You don't give it to the government. You think when you say taxes should be raised, you mean on everybody else. You've
right.
already put your taxable income into a tax-free foundation. You think you're smarter than the
All
government.
Right,
you can spend your money.
I touched
but the
nerve.
Rest of us? No. Pay.gov.
Just
billion
pay
dollars right now.
Grover
Let us know, Bill, that you did this, that
Grover,
you weren't just talking.
Thank you, Grover. Thank you very much.
We can keep going for 20 minutes on this.
Passion, I know. We don't have the time, unfortunately. Grover, thank you very much.